Today we're going to talk about what a loan processor does. Yes, a loan processor. So we've talked about what an underwriter does. We've talked about what a loan originator does. Now it's time to talk about the loan processor. They're kind of like the unsung hero of the loan industry. People don't realize how important processors are, but they are the glue that holds the transaction together. If you have a bad processor, it doesn't matter how good your file is, it's going to be painful, horrible, headache. Doesn't matter. If you have a great processor, even a loan that should be painful and horrible won't be, because they'll be making sure to see everything up front. Okay, so what do they do? Why are they so important? Well, as an originator, it's my job to structure your loan, as we covered before, and come up with a game plan. Right? It's the processor's job to take my game plan and make it a reality. So it's their job to collect all the documents that the underwriter's ultimately gonna want. They need to be very detail-oriented, because it's when they're reviewing your documents, they have to review it as a mini underwriter, because they're trying to anticipate what the underwriter's gonna want. And a lot of times people are like, well, don't you know exactly what documents to get? Yeah, we know the basics of the documents, but sometimes when we review those documents, that's where it opens up a can of worms of other documents we're gonna need. A good processor will figure out that can of worms up front, collect the documents so that when the underwriter reviews it, they go, yes, oh, thank you, Chadwick, Maria, and April, thank you for this beautiful file. And a bad processor, you know, it goes to underwriting and we get back like 75 conditions and a can of worms, and you know, it's just a mess. It's a mess. So a good processor is worth their weight in gold. Yeah, and no one ever talks about the processor. They just think, you know, and one thing that drives me nuts, and I get pretty defensive about is if anyone's ever rude to processors, because I'm like, you guys don't have any idea. Like, you know, the processors on my team, they really, really care about clients, and they care about doing a good job, and they care about, you know, taking care of people. And so when I find out that like a client's been rude or has yelled because they've asked for a document, I get really upset, and I don't get mad at the processor, I call the client. And the reason is that processors are asking for documents so that your loan moves as smoothly as possible. Because the key is, we don't want the underwriter asking a bunch of questions. We want the underwriter to look at our game plan and go, this is great, check. That's what we want. We don't want the underwriter going, oh, I don't know about this. I think we need these other docs. Because all that does is delay you getting approved, which you need as part of your contract. So top tips to buyers would be, processors are gold. Treat them as such. You know, it's pretty funny. Like, and sometimes you will get a bad one. Okay, and if you get a bad one, you're gonna have to talk to your loan originator. If you're working with a different lender and their processor is, you know, not even communicating, and you don't even know it's been 30 days, what the heck is going on? You should be reaching out to the loan originator in that point. I have a different situation with that, because most of my processors are so friendly that they end up, you know, one of them ended up going to Thanksgiving at a client's house. She was at Christmas at another client's house. I think she spent New Year's at yet another client's house. I mean, she's like, she's making friends for life, which is great. And then, you know, other ones are Facebook friends with everyone. Like, it's awesome. It's so great. So you need to look at processors as not this role that you get to yell at, because I think people can get frustrated when they're buying a house, or they get frustrated having to provide documents, and they lash out at the processors because they feel like, you know, they're less likely to lash out at the loan originator because they're like, well, I like Jen, but this person's annoying me. And it's like, no, guys, this person's annoying you because they're the ones taking your dream and making it a reality. So loan processors are so, so important. So important. So top tips for dealing with loan processors: get them what they need as soon as they ask for it. When they send you an email, read it. Yes, and I know it's so easy to skim through stuff. I do the same thing. It's why I'm not a processor. But you really need to read their emails with directions, because with electronic docs and everything else, you can end up locked out. And, you know, they put these stuff, you know, very detailed for you so you succeed. So get them what they need as quickly as possible. Please read their emails in full. Don't make them chase you. Don't. Because here's the thing. If we get to a week before closing and the processors have been reaching out to you and you haven't been providing what they want and you say to me, wait, we're closing late? I'm going to say, yeah. You didn't do your part of the job. Your part of the job is to give my processors what they want. My processors had to call you 32 times. Now, in my case, if my processors have to call someone, you know, more than a couple times, we have another team member reaching out. If I'm calling you asking for docs, that's a sign that you're not being very good. If I'm picking up the phone saying, Paul, we love you, but if you don't give us your docs, we're never going to close your loan. It means that my team has tried so many times, they don't know what to do. So be nice to processors. They are the ones making your dream a reality. I know I've said it twice, but I can't say it enough. If you have any other questions about what a loan processor does, let me know. But the key things are, they are there to get every document the underwriter might want, needs, or asks for. That is their job, okay? Questions, comments, as always, leave them in the body of the YouTube channel or LinkedIn or TikTok or wherever.